Learn how to run .NET apps with Steeltoe in Azure Spring Cloud in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. In this video, we'll create a .NET app and run that in Azure Spring Cloud with Steeltoe. To follow along, you'll need the latest version of the .NET Core SDK, the Azure CLI, and Visual Studio Code. I'll start by creating a new Azure Spring Cloud in the Azure portal. Okay, here we go. First, pick a resource group, and now give it a name, like this. All right. And I'll change the pricing tier as well, to the basic tier, which is fine for this example. Okay. Leave everything else, and let's create it. I'll skip to when it is done. Next, we need to install the Spring Cloud extension for the Azure CLI. Okay. And now I'll make sure that I'm logged into Azure, as we'll need that later. Right, let's create a .NET application. First, I'll create a folder for it. Okay, and navigate to it like this. And now create it. This will be a web API application. That's it. Let's open it in Visual Studio Code. And this is what it looks like. I need to change a few things to make it work with Steeltoe in Azure Spring Cloud. First, I need to change appsettings.json. I need to add these sections to it. Okay. And I also need to change this into information. Later, we'll use this to see more logging information from the app. Okay, now for the project file. I'll add this. These are two packages that I need to use Steeltoe and run in Spring Cloud. And I also added this so that the app publishes to a zip file, which we need for Spring Cloud. All right, let's move on. Now for the program.cs file. First, I need to add this using here. And with that, I can add this line of code. Okay. Next is the startup class. Again, I need to add a using here. And here, in the configure services method, I need to add this line of code. And moving on to the configure method, I need to add this line. All right, that's it. Let's build and publish it. First, I need to go to the Hello World folder. And from there, build it to see if it compiles. Okay, that works. Now I'll publish it to a zip file, which we've indicated in the project file. Okay. And now from here, I'll create an app in the Azure Spring Cloud. An app can run a service and expose it to an endpoint. Okay, that's done. Let's publish the zip file of our .NET app to the Spring Cloud app. There it goes. And let's take a look. Here we are in the Azure Spring Cloud in the Azure portal. Let's go to the apps. Here is the app that we've just created. This is running the .NET app at this URL. Let's see. The API endpoint is this. Okay, this seems to work. Cool. Let's go back. And to the logs menu. And let's see the predefined queries. I'll use this one. And I'll remove the filters on error messages as we log information messages. And there we go. Lots of log messages so that we can see what's going on with our app. Azure Spring Cloud now supports both Java Spring Boot and .NET Steeltoe apps. Go and check it out.